When did you get back in the lineup? You were hurt. How much time did you miss?
I missed like 3 to 4 weeks. I came back right before the McDonough game.
So McDonough was your first game?
Yes, it was.
Sounds good.
So Tuesday, so what did it feel to be out there the first time as a varsity player?
It felt great to be back. The kids, guys have been really helping me get back in the groove, and if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be here.
Pushes it behind quickly. Petro! You know he's going to sound the bell on that. And the Lakers take down the number 2 seed Spalding Cavaliers.
Straight down!
I'm Dom Petronella. I'm an attackman at Boys Latin, and I'm a senior going to North Carolina. I started playing lacrosse when I was like 3 or 4 years old. Basically, as soon as I picked up a stick, I was on Homewood playing. So I committed to North Carolina with my brother, but it was one of those things where like we didn't really talk about our recruiting process. It was kind of, he committed and I decided I wanted to go to North Carolina right around the same time. But he deserved to have that special moment just as much as I did. So I held off on announcing my commitment for a few days because it's just as special to him as it is to me. And he deserves it just as much as anyone else in the world with everything he's gone through. I've loved every moment of playing with him. He's in words I can't describe, a built-in best friend. I wouldn't have asked for it any other way though. I've had expectations thrown on me that sometimes may have been unrealistic, but nothing that's thrown me off my game. My dad's always been great and has always been in a position where he's told us since a young age, if lacrosse isn't for us or we don't want to play, we can play something else. We don't have to play lacrosse just because he did. My whole life I've wanted to be a little different. So kind of just branching off and creating my own legacy for myself rather than creating a legacy revolving around the last name Petronella. When my dad came home after his 2007 national championship was very emotional for him, and the first thing he did when he got home was hug Nick and I, and it just kind of showed me how special this game really was to him and how special it would really mean to me in the years to come. And there are parts of me that realize that there's a chance I coach when I'm older. I'm coaching a younger team right now, but for me it's a lot easier to lead on the field and coach guys through situations than just play and let them figure it out themselves, because that's not going to make us better.
Oh, 1-3, 1-2-3.
Oh, working this way. Keep working it this way. Here we go. Hey, high. You're Chris.
Hey, let's get back here. I'm going here.
So freshman year, I had the luxury of playing with Brendan Grimes and Cam Spencer and Ben Smith, who are three unreal attackmen. And we made it to the semifinals at Towson and ultimately lost to St. Mary's, who we just struggled to beat at any point that year. And sophomore year, we got off to a hot start. We lost to Gonzaga, but it was a really hard fought game. And then COVID shut us down. And then junior year, we kind of all realized what we had lost and how important this game was to us. So it just meant that much more to be back on the field playing. And I feel like that was a huge part of our championship run, was we really have something special here and we don't want to waste it. That's a feeling I can't even describe. It was one of those things where you just have to live in the moment and just let everything come to you as it does. It was a bunch of emotions all at once. And as it hit you, you just got happier as the night went on. And that moment with my dad is something I'll never forget. It's something that I may never get to do again, but just being able to share a moment like that with him and with my brother and with the rest of my teammates who are indefinitely family to me is just something super special. And now we're here in my senior year, and I've had the luxury of all 4 years playing with great attackmen that hasn't changed. Now playing with Nicky Brown, who's going to Jacksonville, and Spencer Ford, who just got named a 5-star. And it's just this special chemistry I constantly build with these attackmen, no matter how we rotate them or who rotates in. Between that and then our midfield and then the rest of our team, it's just a special bond we all have together.
Good time to get some extra work, right? We've got plenty of balls, beautiful day, open goals, plenty of time to get some extra work. You guys want to do that? But I thought that was a good go. It really was. It was a good little hour for you guys. And you young guys, way to pay attention as well. All right, bring it out.
Hop on you.
0-1-3, 1-2-3, oh!
What'd you say?
Where'd you take that?
Well, I had to take the Nike logo. Alright, cool.
Okay. And you want to, like, almost like.
So really exaggerate.
Like, yeah, like fall towards the goal kind. Because that'll get your hips going through. Yeah.
There you go. It's only
TL. Like this, and then you're getting into it. You gotta be like, you're actually shooting. Three, four. You shot that in 5 steps. Taking too long, you know?
And you're in charge of backing that ball up. Has everybody got that attack? When you guys see that, you guys let us know. All right? Everything else, we've gone over. And again, I don't care about what they're doing. I care about us. From here on out, it's about us. It's about getting ready for next Tuesday. Everything we do is about us. And what's the theme for today? Like it just was on Saturday? Support, right? We're supporting each other. Good play, bad play, whatever it is. We support one another. All right?
Yes, sir.
Hey, so we're back on Lake Avenue, man.
Is yeah! Yeah!
Lakers!
We walk off together as a team. All right, see that?
Let's go, boys.
Ray Roll Hoyas, 1, 2, 3.
Ray Roll Hoyas!
Hey, Ray Roll Hoyas!
Hey, Ray Roll Hoyas!
humble and cocky as hell. Shout out my just to answer my call when I call the collectors, it got me through hell. Shout out that jack that denied me my belt. It made me smarter and made me go harder. They locked me up and sold my album up, but I did not give up cause I knew I would prevail. Came in the game, Philly is. Look at these rappers, they silly as. I don't know why they be guessing these suckers, but cause I am not feeling they. Different between me and most of these rappers, I'm talking about work that I really put in. Talking about pistols I put on my hip, and I'm talking about foreigns I really could whip that I really didn't drove. Really was frozen in my hood, and these bitches I really did hit. Really was shows. Came up from nothing, and now they like I ain't made millions so quick. I'm in the back, and they feel like a sofa. I done seen bitches I'm fucking on over. In my new mansion, I feel like I'm Sosa. A brick on the table, ain't sniffing no coke in nowhere. All I wanted was a new Mercedes.
Right now, I mean, we've preached on don't worry about the playoffs to come, just worry about the next game. So right now, we're just focused on St. Paul's, who's a really good team, and they're fighting for a spot in the playoffs. So we're more focused on what we need to do to earn ourselves a direct trip to Navy Marine Corps rather than what the playoff picture looks like for us.